Hello, Lauren Carr here for Daily Vibe Check. So it is Thursday, July 1st. We are halfway through the year. I don't know how to, and I have a live audience. In stereo. So we're going to see what Spirit wants us to know for our greatest and highest good. This is the last day that Mandy and April are going to be with me, unless I can convince them to stay longer. So we're enjoying our time together. All right, so let's see what Spirit wants us to know today, what we need to embrace, what we need to avoid, what we need to know about. All right, in general, overall vibe, what do we need to know about Thursday, July 1st? Ooh, Knight of Wands. It's one of my favorite, Knight of Wands. So knights are doers. I've talked about this a number of times. Knights are doers. So knights get up on their horse, they go out, and wands are fiery, passionate. So you see, I like all the fire and stuff back here. And also, like, I'm a Leo, so I really relate to wands, and I'm a tap dancer. And so, like, there's the rhythm. I'm digging this card. And also, let's talk about, look, see that? Look at that.
My mom.
That's beautiful. Look at that. Beautiful. Yep. Knights are doers. So in a relationship, it's passionate. It's great sexual energy and chemistry. In pursuit of passions, like if you decide, I really want to do this, it's time to get on the horse and go. Okay. See, get on the horse and just go. All right. Oh, and, you know, and as a recent past, maybe you've already decided, you know what? I'm going for it. Okay. Oh, I just kind of picked up two cards on accident. Ew, why is this sticky? All right. Well, if I picked up like this, then this would be the next card. All right, the moon. Moon is some sort of hidden energy. So there's something hidden that you're like, something that you're not quite seeing. So it's like whole, yeah, I'm going, and you're not quite sure what you're going into. Okay. But then the next card is the Five of Swords reversed as the future. Now fives are conflict. Swords are intellect. I always think like the scientific mind. See how these fit together. So with this Five of Wands reverse, it's like the end of some sort of conflict. So if you are dead set, oh, here we go. So if you're like, I know something's happening, I know something's hidden, I have a gut feeling about something, and I see it, I feel it, but I don't know what it is. So you are on a mission. It's being on a mission to uncover something. It's just understanding intuitively that you know something and you're on a mission. And then you get to it and you're like, oh, wait, that wasn't actually a thing. So this challenges you. I'm getting the drop jaw over here. So that means she's pulled a card that means something. Oh, by the way, we're playing a fun game today. So I'm going to pull these cards, and then April and Mandy are going to pull a card from each of their decks, and I get to interpret it however I feel the need to interpret it. See how it fits into this. So it's kind of a fun game. So this is kind of saying, okay, you might be fiery, you might be passionate, you might be driven, you might be like, yeah, I'm going to find all the answers. And you might be kind of a little paranoid that something's hidden. And you might finally uncover it and realize, oh, wait, it's not that big of a deal. Okay. All right, give me a card. Resilience, finding your limits. Yeah. I don't want to read that. Hold on. Okay. She has the book, and I like, realistically, I should read the book, but I kind of want to go off of this intuitively. Okay, so check out this card. First of all, dragons, amazing. And I love that this is like a cold breathing dragon, but you've got that little burning fire down there, right? Very much like this vibe. See the relation, overall vibe, and the colors and everything. So I feel like this is saying that maybe you are on a mission. You're uncovering something. You are just on a mission to uncover something. You're passionate about it. You're gonna discover something that you feel like is hidden. And once it kind of surfaces, you're like, oh, well, okay. Wasn't what I thought. Or maybe you weren't successful in uncovering this thing that you intuitively know is there. And at some point, you have to find your limits. You have to, at some point, you have to say, is there really something hidden, or am I making stuff up? Okay. And how do you bounce back from that? How do you recognize your own faults, and how do you recognize your own paranoia about something? All right, next.
I didn't even look at it.
You are good enough. Is amazing. Also, it matches my shirt. Look at that. Yeah. You are good enough. So bouncing back from something that you think you know, you are convinced you know, there's some deep dark secret, and you realize, apparently it's not. But then how do you feel? So think about it. Okay. Okay, I've got an analogy. Like, I feel like this came up in MDH. This came up in MDH. It's about, oh, my foot's asleep. So you know how, and this may be a Gen X thing, I don't know. It may not be, but it might just be a Gen X thing. Well, my parents spanked me and I turned out all right. Did you really? Did you really? I didn't have dishwasher and I turned out okay, but did you? Because you seem a little salty, right? So when we grow up with being told and raised in certain values, okay, we're raised in certain values. We are told certain things, and then we get to be adults, and I am the epitome of the black sheep of the family. Like the epitome, like textbook. When you get to a point where you're starting to question what's right, what's wrong, what do I really feel, what do I really believe in, then if you look back and you go, oh my gosh, my parents are raving lunatics, or my grandparents, or my uncle, or the fun uncle that you thought was so amazing and so great, they're lunatics. But if I said that out loud, then I'm discounting everything I ever was. If I disagree, then I'm discounting my elders who I looked up to and valued. So does that make me less of a person? Does that make me less of a human being? Does this make me a bad person? So fiery, passionate person, going for it, right? Things that are hidden kind of come to the surface, or you discover them because you're fiery and passionate, and realize, oh, well, maybe they're not as bad as I thought, or maybe they're worse than I thought. How do you come back from that? Ask yourself what your belief system is, where you got it. This is a perfect time. As far as universally, like to question your belief system. What were you raised with? Do you believe it? Were you raised in Catholic school where they said like what you had like a very limited belief system? It's not just Catholic school, it'd be any school, but my family, looking at the trend, looking at like the past, it makes sense to me. What have you been told? What have you been told about gay people? What have you been told about black people? What have you been told about Mexican people? What have you been told about anyone that's not white in Middle America, Midwest America? Okay, so what are you uncovering? What are you discovering? And realizing, oh, wait, it's not that deep. It's not the problem we thought it was. How do you come back from that? And then how do you say, well, if I was raised this way, my parents don't believe this, my grandparents don't believe this, and generationally, genetically, DNA related, whatever, all the trends from all of that, am I invalid? If I say I disagree with what my parents or grandparents or whoever raised me believe, this is saying you're good enough. You are good enough. Your belief system, what you believe, what you feel is good enough. And you know what? No matter what we've been told and what we've been raised with, we can bounce back from it. We have resilience. And at some point, you do find your limits. At some point, you go, okay, well, I think I've had enough of the racism. I think I've had enough of the politics. I think I've had enough of the, I can't leave the house without having full makeup and head of hair, you know, great hair and great makeup to go to the convenience store for milk. You know, it's okay. This, I feel like this is all saying in self-discovery, it's okay to realize that you are different than the people that raised you. And you are not discounting them. You're not dishonoring them by not going along with what they've said. You are evolving. You are changing. You are raising the vibration of everyone around you. And it's not as conflictual as you think. Personal experience, my mom, for all the things that I thought I was terrified to bring up to her, she's been like, oh man, great point. I never thought of it that way. Who knew that was going to happen? You know, she's been very open to evolving and change. Maybe instead of assuming that what you've been told and what you've been raised with, and if you have parents or grandparents or authority figures or even mentors, bosses that have very set opinions and this is how we do it, don't just go get caught up in that. Make sure you know, respectfully, of course, show the evolution and understand that even if they don't agree, you are still worth it. You are still worth everything that you believe in, and you being able to, there is going to be a point where you're like, yeah, so no, can't that, you know, I can tolerate a lot, but that crossed the line. You can say it respectfully. You can voice your opinion. And if they get upset, that's on them. As long as you're not, don't be a jerk. Do not be a jerk about it. Just go in truth, function in light, love, and good intentions, high vibrations, and the negativity will fall away. Any thoughts, comments, opinions from the peanut gallery over here? I mean, my love audience.
Nailed it on the head.
Yep. Yeah, that's what I thought.
I had the book spot on.
Oh, okay. So I've been mine too. Excellent. I like it. Because so for the record, these are not my cards. Mandy's cards, April's cards. I've never seen the books. I've never seen this, but I can tell you like how they, I can tell you how they fit in. They really resonated. All right. Like, subscribe, all the good stuff. Share. Reach out for a reading. I still do personal readings. Sign session coming up. Sign session. I just did the graphics today. Updated my website. Also, check out my new website. It's not new. I just changed the name and I actually paid for it. Finally. After 8 years, I finally got rid of the .weebly.com. It's just now.
Spirits from the other side.
Spirit messages from the other side. .com. No Weebly, just .com. .com. I feel like it's a commercial.
Right?
.com.
It is kind of .com.
Yeah, like we're all in the same spirit tune with that. I feel
from
like
the other side.
.com.
Please check out her website.
Check out the website. But anyway, sign session July 21st. Sounds about right.
Sign session.
Only $30. $30, you get, we have limited seating, and you'll get messages from Dana, Angie, and myself. Between Oracle cards, Mandy's going to be there. Oracle cards, tarot cards, pendulums. I do mediumship readings. I know that actually Angie's been developing her mediumship skills even more. So it's always an incredible time. Highly recommend it.
Yes.
I'll be there with bells on. All right. Have a fantastic day, and I will see you tomorrow. Bye.